Hi students, today our topic is magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron. Okay, so consider one electron is revolving in a circular path of radius around the nucleus. Okay, it is a nucleus. If electron is revolving around the nucleus in circular path of radius is r. Okay, consider one electron. This electron is revolving in a circular path of radius r around the nucleus with a constant speed. Okay, with a constant speed electron. It is rotating in a circular path means it having time period. Its time period is equal to t is equal to 2 pi by omega. What is omega? Angular velocity or angular frequency. You know v is equal to r omega. Omega is equal to v by r. Substituting here t is equal to 2 pi by omega v by r, that means time period t is equal to 2 pi r by v. Okay, time period t is equal to here 2 pi r by v. Here electron is revolving in circular path means it is in motion. In motion it produces the current. Okay, here developed current I is equal to charge of electron is E. Time period in one revolution developed current is I. So charge by time means time period. E by t means what is t here? 2 pi r by v is taken upon ev by 2 pi r. Here developed current is equal to EV by 2 pi r. Okay, I is equal to EV by 2 pi r. Magnetic moment here represented with mu is equal to current into area. What is current here? EV by 2 pi r. Area means pi r square. Pi r cancel. Magnetic moment is equal to here EV r by 2. What is E? Charge of electron. V means velocity. R means radius of the circular path. Once again, if the electron revolving in a circular path of radius r around the nucleus with a constant speed v. Okay, so to complete one revolution it takes the time. Simply that is called as time period. Time period t is equal to 2 pi by omega. You know relation v is equal to r omega. Omega is equal to v by r. Substituting here t is equal to 2 pi r by v. I is equal to, that means here in one revolution developed current is equal to charge by time. Okay, so charge is electron charge E. Time period means 2 pi r by v. So v taken upon EV by 2 pi r. You know magnetic moment mu is equal to current into area. Okay, so EV by 2 pi r into pi r square. Here means pi r square. On simplification, magnetic moment is equal to EVR by 2. Okay. Now here, mu is equal to EVR by 2. EVR by 2. From this one, Vr is write as 2 mu by E. 2 mu by V. Okay, 2 is taking this side. E is taking this side. 2 mu by E. Now, here, magnetic moment of the electron, revolving electron in a hydrogen, okay, first orbit is called as Bohr magneton. Okay, you know already, okay, magnetic moment of a revolving electron in first orbit of a hydrogen atom is called Bohr magneton. You know already this one. Okay, magnetic moment of a revolving electron in first orbit of a hydrogen atom is called Bohr magneton. Understood? Okay, you know already this one. Now, from Bohr's second postulate, okay, from Bohr's second postulate, what is second postulate for revolving electron in first orbit of a hydrogen atom? Okay, revolving electron, okay, in first orbit of hydrogen atom, angular momentum is equal to mvr is equal to h by 2 pi. You know already generally mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. But here in first orbit n is equal to 1. First orbit n is equal to 1. So mvr is equal to h by 2 pi. But here vr is equal to, what is the vr here? M. Vr in the sense 2 mu by E is equal to h by 2 pi. Okay. Mu is equal to, it is taking this side, E h by 2 is taking 4 pi m. Understood? Mu is equal to E h by 4 pi m. What is E? Charge of electron. What is H? Planck's constant. 4 constant, pi constant, m means mass of electron. Okay, here E means charge of electron. What's that value? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Okay, m means mass of electron. 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. What is H? H means Planck's constant. The value is 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34. Okay. So, substituting the values in Bohr magneton. Substituting here, mu is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, h 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 by 4, pi means 3.14 into 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31. Its value 9.27 into 10 to the power of minus 24 ampere meter square. Okay. Simply, this value is called, Bohr magneton. okay, this value is called Bohr magneton. Okay, so you know magnetic moment of a revolving electron in first orbit of a hydrogen atom is called as Bohr magneton. Bohr magneton. So second postulate of the Bohr is equal to angular momentum mvr is equal to h by 2 pi m 2 mu by e. So h by 2 pi, generally this is the formula, and h by 2 pi n value is equal to 1. So mu is equal to h by 4 pi m. E means charge of electron, m means mass of electron, h means Planck's constant. Okay, substituting the values, final value is 9.27 × 10⁻²⁴. Okay, ampere meter square, this value is called as Bohr magneton. Okay, now here one problem. If two charged particles, each of charge q, mass m, are connected to the ends of a rigid massless rod and is rotated about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the length, then find the ratio of magnetic moment to angular moment. Okay, consider two masses. These are connected with massless rod. Okay, it is rotated about an axis perpendicular to the length. Understood? Okay, so its length L by 2, its length is also L by 2. Understood? Now first of all find out the magnetic moment. Magnetic moment is equal to IA. I means current. These two are rotated. These two are rotated means current, two charges, 2q by time period is t. 2q by t. Okay. Area. Area pi r square. R means here radius is L by 2. Radius is L by 2. So L by 2 whole square. Okay. 2q pi L square by t means 2 pi by omega 4. L by 2 whole square means L square by 4. Pi as usual. 2q. T means 2 pi by omega. Okay. 2 pi. 2 pi cancel. Omega is taken upon. Q omega L square by 4. Here developed magnetic moment is Q omega L square by 4. Okay. It is magnetic moment. Angular moment is equal to L is equal to mvr. Okay. M, V means R omega into R, MR square omega, R in the sense L by 2 here, M, L by 2 whole square into omega, M, L square by 4 into omega, ML square by 4 into omega. Substituting here, required ratio, M by L, Q omega L square by 4. Okay. Sorry. Here masses are 2. Masses are 2. See. L is equal to each one mvr. Total 2 massive particles. So 2 mvr. 2 m. V means R omega into R. Now 2 MR square into omega. 2 M R means L by 2 whole square into omega. 2 M L square by 4 into omega. 2 to cancel. ml square omega by 2. ml square omega by 2. It is angular momentum. Angular momentum L is equal to ml square omega by 2. So m means q omega square, q omega L square by 4. Okay, this one m L square omega by 2. Okay, 2 times L square, omega, omega cancel. Remaining part q by 2 m. So magnetic moment to angular moment is equal to q by 2m. Once again, so two massive particles, each mass m, okay, rotate about an axis passing through center perpendicular to the length. So magnetic moment, developed magnetic moment is equal to ia. Here charge is 2. Because of two charged particles, the charge is q, the charge is also q. Okay, 2q by t, area pi r square. R means l by 2 whole square. So magnetic moment is equal to q omega l square by 4. Angular moment is equal to generally mass into linear velocity into radius. Okay, here two massive particles, for this one mvr, for this one mvr, total 2mvr. 2m, v means r omega, r, 2m r square omega, r in the sense l by 2. Okay, so on simplification, angular moment is equal to ml square omega by 2. Required ratio is magnetic moment to angular moment m by l. M by l on simplification q by 2m. Okay.